This video was made possible by Skillshare. Use the link below to get a 1 month free trial of online classes where you can learn just about anything. Starting out in astrophotography can be quite difficult. There are lots of new terms to learn, some of them more important than others. But if you have seen backyard astrophotographers taking images like these and want to do the same, there is one step you cannot get around: calibration. This is the second video in a series where I will try to do my best to explain what calibration is, how to do it, and what these calibration frames are. You already know about the bias frame. If not, I highly recommend watching the latest video. And in this one, I will talk about the next very important calibration frame, the dark frame. My name is Tim and welcome back to AstroAddict. Here we are in my editing software. Just like last time, I loaded my image of the Pinwheel Galaxy. And just like last time, it looks quite horrible. We again have dust, vignetting, readout noise, also known as bias noise, amplifier glow and hot and cold pixels. That's what you would expect for a deep sky stacked image. All of these errors without calibration are in the final image. In the last video, we already talked about bias noise, also known as readout noise. By using bias frames, we can calibrate our light frames before stacking to get rid of that stupid extra type of noise. And in this video, let's concentrate on two other very annoying types of defects: amplifier glow and dark noise. Since this is a stack right here, we can't really see the dark noise. It gets better as soon as we stack many images, but we can see the amplifier glow. Over here in the top right, you can almost see like light streaks entering the image. Let me show you over here. And if I go down in the corner, it also glows a bit brighter than the rest of the image. Also down here, this is basically the same type of amp glow, only flipped, because in the middle of the night we sometimes have to perform a flip of the image to continue tracking the object. In order to understand better what dark frame actually is, let's take a look at one of them. I have a stacked master dark frame prepared already. This is a stack of 5 minute dark exposures with the camera, with my dedicated astronomy camera, the ASI 294. We see the three types of amp glow, or three areas of amp glow. Of course, over here, as if a very bright star is in that corner, to the left, and on the bottom here where it glows a bit, no light beams. But we can see these light beams here beautifully. And we also see lots of red and blue pixels, basically hot and cold pixels. Dark frames from different cameras can look quite different, but all DSLRs and most of the entry-level astronomy cameras have one thing in common: amplifier glow. The amplifier is a device located behind the camera sensor. Before the saved electrons are converted into digital units, they pass the amplifier, which, depending on the ISO, literally amplifies the current. The problem is, this amplifier can get quite warm. And whenever something gets warm, it starts to glow in infrared or near infrared. And it heats up the sensor at the same time, which is always bad. We cannot see infrared light, but a camera sensor can. These are the light beams we see in this dark frame. Getting rid of those is very important before we stack our light frames. The exact appearance of amp glow can differ from camera to camera, but most of the time it manifests as a glow in one or two edges of the image. But that's not the only defect we need to correct. Most people talk about noise in a broad term, which includes many different types of noise. I have a small list here just to remember all of them. The types of noise I got to know in astrophotography and in my image processing classes at the university: bias, banding, dark, shot, walking, high amp, hot and cold pixels. Dark frames also capture dark noise, which is mostly random. Dark noise is best attacked by using lots and lots of light frames in the stack, but also by calibrating with a dark frame. Depending on your camera, you might start to see some regularities when you stack lots of dark frames. And these are the regularities we need to calibrate with a master dark frame. But even if a dark frame from a camera looks decent, with no hot pixels, no amp glow, always use dark frames. The strength of this dark noise depends on three factors: exposure time, ISO, and sensor temperature. Therefore, if you want to take a dark frame, these three factors need to be the same as in your light frames. Your imaging night is over and you collected lots of good images on a distant object. At the end of the night, your DSLR might be on low battery power, but right then is the best time to take dark frames. That's why I had a replacement battery ready just for that purpose. Exposure time and ISO are not the big obstacles when it comes to taking dark frames. The temperature is. At the end of the night, try to get at least 20 dark frames before the camera changes its temperature too much. And when I say too much, I don't have a well-researched value you can follow. Only as a recommendation, I would not take dark frames with more or less than 5 degrees Celsius in temperature difference. The resulting image would still be noisy or damaged data. If you don't get a chance to take them in the same night, I recommend waiting one night to place the camera outside with about the same outside temperature. And then you can capture the remaining dark frames. I've also seen people putting the camera in the fridge, but that only works if you are shooting in the winter, not in the summer. In a warm summer night, a DSLR can reach up to 30 degrees Celsius. And if you want to calibrate properly, you need dark frames with 30 degrees Celsius, which is not possible in the fridge. Sadly, dark frames will not remove all of the noise in your image. They only reduce one type of noise, which originates from heated electrons. They will not tackle most of the other types of noise, which could be a video in and of itself. The best ways to keep your Astro images noise-free are: cool the camera if possible, use a low ISO, calibrate with dark frames, dither, and stack as many light frames as possible into a beautiful deep sky image. And the good thing about that, you can learn all of that right here on this channel. But if you came here to learn how to animate awesome characters, get better at online marketing, or create your first musical masterpiece, you are definitely in the wrong place. That's why I'm glad that this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community containing thousands of classes for anyone who wants to learn new skills and grow with their creativity. Last time I mentioned Jordi's awesome classes on Adobe Premiere Pro, and this time I listened to his introduction to lighting in videography, which is why I took some more time to arrange my lights in the studio and added a small bonus over there. The first 1000 people to use this link will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. So be sure to head over there right now to redeem your first steps in a new world of creativity. Now back to the dark frames. To sum it up, the dark frame is used to correct for amp glow and dark noise. Put the cap on the camera or telescope and shoot images which have the same exposure time and ISO as the light frames you took in the night. The temperature of the camera matters, and you should take these dark frames right after the light frames in the same night to get as close as you can. If you have a cooled, dedicated camera, you are in luck. With controllable temperature, you can prepare as many darks as you want beforehand and just store them away for later use. And they can be stored for quite some time. The sensor of a camera does deteriorate over time, but you don't need to take new dark frames every session. Again, that's only a recommendation, not a fact verified through research. But with my ASI 294, I take a new set of dark and bias frames every year, and calibration works out fine. Thank you so much for watching. As always, feel free to leave questions and feedback down below. Thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video, and I will see you in the next one, where I will talk about the last calibration frame to sum this series up. And as for me, my name is Tim, I am an Astro Addict. I wish you clear skies, and may the night be with us.